Good morning everyone. I would like to start the class today. Yesterday we had been learned community, nature of community, types of community, then detail about rural community. Mainly focus on rural problems. We are nursing professional responsible to solve healthcare problems in rural communities. So we need to know about allied issues. So health is directly linked with economic, agriculture, as well as other related issues. So today we are going to start with measures to solve rural problems. Rural problems. Rural planning and reconstruction. Rural planning is the process of improving the quality of life and economic well-being rich in natural resources. Keywords: improving the quality of life and well-being. Next heading: methods of reconstruction. First, improvement of agriculture. As we had been learned yesterday, various kind of agricultural issues. First improvement is that new methods, mainly genetically modified seed, machines used for agriculture should be used scientific methods. Then modified tools including for cultivation and cropping should be used modified tools to improve productivity. Next, organized farms. As we had been learned, in India, small farms, every farm should be coordinate and organized to improve productivity. Then water management. For example, drip irrigation. Second, economic reconstruction. First, reconstruction, cooperative societies. In every villages now having agricultural cooperative societies provide financial services for agriculture. Next, easy financial access for loan facilities, then cooperative bank, the farmers together and organize bank collaborate with central and state governments to reconstruct rural economy. Next, infrastructure development. For example, storage facilities for improving the production as well as better storage and industries. Next, organize businesses mainly export the products which is produced in the villages. Then reduce the middleman. As we know that if farmers produce an agricultural product, the maximum of money earned by middlemen, for example, a brinjal produced by farmer, the middleman go to farm and only 10 rupees purchase and sell it 50 rupees and 60 rupees. So who is earning more money? Middleman. That's why nowadays government various programs. And farmers can produce the products and directly sell to the people. There is no the mediators. And all money goes to farmers. Next, enact law. New legislations are needed for better earning and reconstruction, economic reconstruction. Then social reconstruction. First, educational facilities. Every village needs schools. Next, employment opportunities. Eradicate unemployment. Then healthcare infrastructure. For example, primary healthcare centers. Then disease prevention and control. Mainly communicable diseases. Then environmental protection to manage the global warming and promote environmental health. Then eradication of social disabilities. The social disabilities including religious disabilities and other types of disabilities should be removed to reconstruct social well-being in the rural community. Then panchayat system, community development programs, etc. So these all the reconstruction of rural community. Next, we are going to detail about rural planning and reconstruction. Aim of rural planning: affecting an improvement in all aspect of rural life, not only this economic life, physical, mental, mainly healthier life. Then objectives: eradication of poverty by means of reconstruction of cottage industries, establishment of cooperative societies, improvement of transportation. Second objective is that spread of education, free and fair education. Next, progress of health, physical health, mental health, and social well-being. Then abolition of social malpractices like casteism and untouchability, etc. Then developing best type of village leadership. Now people only govern the modern villages. Then undertaking various economic and educational moral programs. Achieving rural reconstruction. In Indian villages, maximum of villages, people filled with superstitious belief. Need to educate the people regarding morality and reality. Then successes of rural reconstruction. First, there should be a cumulative growth in each successful field. Cumulative means collaborate with other sectors. Then there should be proper coordination. As we know that in rural reconstruction, lack of coordination between the departments, for example, health, transportation, coordination is needed to equal development. Then agricultural productivity should be increased through adaptation of improved agriculture by means of mechanization, computerization, mainly use scientific methods. Then level of education should be raised in every sections of the population in rural India. Next, institutions of the rural community should be transformed, for example, lower to higher. Mainly family should be transformed to high quality and standard. Seventh one, local people responsibilities. People participation is primary to rural development. Then there should be adequate provision, services, and physical resources. So which means this should be utilize the resources which is available in every villages. Next, efforts should be made accelerate rural industrialization and eliminate unemployment. Students, this is a new concept, you know, rural industrialization. Now industry is only available in cities, but nowadays the industries migrated to villages, so village can able to grow. Tenth one, balance human and material resources. What resources available, that aspect of development plan is needed. So every villages need different plan and according to their resources as well as their opportunities in rural community. Next section, panchayat system. Modern Indian villages are governed by panchayat system. The origin of the system is that Balbandari Committee recommendation in 1958. Next, technique of democratic decentralization. Decentralization means every village can take their own decision. They don't depend upon central government or state government. every villager take their own decision for their progresses. So this is by Nehru in 1959, was by then Constitution 73rd Amendment. So impact of this democratic decentralization techniques, new Constitution Amendment in 1973, 73rd Amendment is passes Panchayat Raj Act. Look at this picture, students. So this is a organizational structure of the Indian government, state government, central government, state government, then division, district. Each district divided into block, municipal corporations, municipality, and city council. Then blocks are divided into, blocks means taluks, divided into villages, then which may be called as gram panchayat. You know, look here, wards. In municipalities, municipal corporations, only one ward member only for each ward. But every villages are governed by three tier system. For example, one ward member, one union member, then one member district council. So every village citizen choose three members to govern the Indian villages, which is unique. Indian villages governed by panchayat system. Then organization of these panchayats. Three tier system. First, villages are gram panchayat at village level, panchayat union or panchayat samit at block or taluk level, zilla parishad or district development council at district level. So three tier system, as we had seen that in that organizational chart. Look at this flow chart. Then salient features of Panchayat Raj. First, promote agriculture, rural industry. Then provision of maternity, women, child health. Next, maintenance of roads, tanks and wells. Then provision of sanitation and drainage system. Then socio-economic progress, primary education, land revenue, execution of rural development program. Then power and functions of gram panchayat, sanitation and drainage, prevention of public nuisances, curative and preventive measures in respect of any epidemic as well as pandemic. Then supply of drinking water and disinfecting the source of supply and storage of water. Example, chlorination of waters, clean water. Then maintenance, repair, construction, protection of public streets. For safe transportation. Then removal of encroachment of public street or public places. Next, management and care of public tanks. Then organizing voluntary labor for upliftment of its areas. So develop their own villages, by its own people. So next section, community development program. What is meant by community development, CDP, as a process of social action which the people of community organized themselves for planning action to meet their common needs and solve their problems. So this is CDP is a short form. This question may be asked this only. Write short notes on CDP. The examination, this is very important question. Keywords are social action, people organize themselves, you know, every citizen in the villages involved, planning action and solve their own problems within self, which is supported by central government, state government, as well as international organizations. Then salient features of CDP will be learned next class. Today's class is going to end. Thank you for watching. Now is question time.